Hey, I'm Stacey. Dyna dwi'n meddwl o'n gannau. As you might know, I'm a fashion design student. And on June 1st, I just submitted my degree collection to my last ever assessment and bachelor's degree. Because this channel is dedicated towards me showing everything that I do with my degree collection development and fashion in general, I thought that would only be fair if I shown you everything that I submitted this time. Now, I do want to note that this submission looks very different than it was supposed to look like because of the pandemic and the whole corona situation. So I wanted to give you a little bit of an outline what the submission would have looked like and what it actually looks like right now. Because the social distancing and remote studies started right at the time when we were supposed to start sewing the collection because we make it ourselves, we did not really have much time to finish anything. I only managed to finish one pair of trousers and sort of outline another look, but we had to start a digital submission, which is the first ever in our university's practice, and I'm pretty sure in many other fashion universities' practice. So digital submission means that we are not sewing anything for the final collection. We're actually sort of imagining what the collection would have looked like. The typical submission would be a fully finished 6-look collection that you made yourselves in the studio with very developed prints, samples. That would also mean you would have a sample book, a finishing book, a 15-page A3 sketchbook, a range plan, a fully developed portfolio, about 20 pages or more, a technical specification range plan, commercial diffusion range plan, evaluation rationale, and lookbook. Because typically, once you finish a collection, you would also have a photo shoot, video shoot. You would use those materials for promotional materials such as lookbook or other different like postcards or anything else. You would make a video, and in June, at this stage right now, actually during this week, we would have an exhibition in our university, and there we would also use some different little materials if we had time to create them, such as shoes or customized bags or accessories. So typically, that would be a large amount of handwork accompanied by digital work. But because this time we're going for a digital submission, it meant that we had to focus on digital strictly without actually making anything physical. We still had to move all of our stuff back home in hopes that we would be back and running in the studio within the next couple of weeks, but as we know now, that did not happen, and we had to stay home and change the entire model of our course, not us obviously, but our tutors. But we had to adapt to it, so there were a lot of changes that went through. Now, regarding our actual digital submission, I'm not going to be going too in-depth explaining them right now, because while I'm going to be showing, I'll explain what the things are actually for. I'm just going to outline them. It's still an A3 sketchbook, it's still an illustrated final collection range plan, but typically the range plan that we would make when the collection is finished would be models wearing a garment taking a 360 shot, and now instead of that we are illustrating it in Illustrator or by hand or any other media that you wish. Then portfolio stays the same, technical range plan stays the same, evaluation and rationale stay the same, but we had an extra thing, which is technical specification range plan, which I'm going to be explaining a bit later on again. I think that is all regarding the extra additive illustrations and everything, but we were advised to do something else. You could add some extra materials because we're not doing any lookbooks or photo shoots or video shoots, so our tutor suggested that we could try anything in digital work, so I'll be showing you everything that I've done so far as well. So let's get into it. I'll be showing everything on the screen.
Our assessment was broken down into two modules, and I kept my work organized the same way on my desktop, broken down into two different folders, as it was uploaded to Google Drive where we had our digital submission. I'll open the first folder and begin with my degree collection range plan. So what is a range plan? Essentially, it's quite simple. It's a lineup of all of your designs altogether. Typically, you would want to use a model that does not distract from the clothing, and you would want to use the same model throughout the whole range plan so that it would look cohesive and uniform. Because you are looking at a collection from the view of every look side by side, you can see whether or not they interact with each other well, if the collection looks cohesive, if the prints work next to each other, and you would place them in the same order as you would like to see them go down the runway. Range plans are very helpful for unifying the collection, especially if you're focused on one look and then you put it into a range plan and you see that it doesn't really go along with anything. You can just lower a waistline, raise a hemline or something for it to repeat the same height, the same level on other design, and it automatically makes it a bit more cohesive. In my case, as you can see, the designs are quite out there and it's not something that you would see go down the runway and then immediately want to buy perhaps, but they are still repetitive in some cases. You can see reoccurring prints from look number 1 on look number 4 and 6. You can see the same hemline on look number 2 and 4. You can see that reoccurring shoulder pads are repeated on look number 2, 4, and 6. The same body print on look number 1, 5, 6. So there's a lot of repetition, and I have not even outlined everything. Degree collections are not meant to be simple. or commercial or runway ready. They are a chance for a degree student to express all their creativity, playfulness, with silhouette, with print, with layering, with the structure, with anything basically. And once we apply to jobs, this is going to be part of our portfolio and probably the major part of it, because it's the final project where we express everything that we've learned throughout the 4 years in university. And typically that is the extension of yourself, that is the extension of your current feeling, of your current position within fashion industry. And once you apply to jobs, that's going to be representative of your, I don't know, craziest out there project. Now we're moving on to a commercial range plan, which would actually be something that a person could wear, inspired by my prints, inspired by my collection, but not exactly an extension of it. So we were told not to just directly copy and simplify look number one, look number six, and so on, but we were told to take a direction. And in my case, because I was somewhat looking into airport and the travel, my tutor suggested that I maybe look into airport crew clothing and what people wear. So I chose sort of like a loungewear, simple, very comfy, easy clothing to travel with, and I adapted a couple of pieces. So you obviously see that some prints are reoccurring, and I think leggings from look number five are essentially a repetition of what I have in my actual degree collection, but because they are simplified with a beige top, they don't look this heavy, this loaded. And the whole collection itself does not really have much thought put into it, because I had enough research with print, with textile development. I just tried to unify it with color, with the actual topic in mind. So you can see a little belly bag, belt bag on look number four, which sort of is an adapted version of that giant sculpture backpack that I had on look number two in my actual collection. I think if I were to choose, I mean, I love all of those looks and I would actually wear them, so I might be making those in the future, but I think in that case look number one would be something that I would be eager to recreate and wear myself, because I absolutely love those leggings. The leggings themselves, I really wanted to introduce a sustainable manufacturing option for the actual commercial collection. Even though this is a bit more time consuming process, I think using scraps of fabric from body prints, it could be interesting for implementing into actual patchworky leggings. I think that could be an awesome way, and I think that's the way fashion industry should be viewing commercial collections and like simplified range plans, as a way of adapting your fabric scraps. I don't think throwing out fabric scraps is even an option, so I do like the introduction of that idea, at least in one look out of the six. Now we're moving on to my technical specification range plan. It's front and back view, it's quite simple. Essentially it's the same range plan, just without any color or print. I'm not the biggest fan of it, because somehow it feels to me that I managed to overcomplicate and make it look even more difficult and overloaded without the print and without the color. I don't know why, it just feels like it to me. I do recognize that it is important to have a technical range plan, because it allows the viewer to see and focus just on silhouettes alone without anything to distract them, and that's why I did two back views, because I had to show the person that the backpack can be removed and the silhouette changes dramatically. I think this could only be useful for you to see how the little details are repeated throughout the look. So essentially from the back, look number one and three look quite similar. If you delete that little sculptural element from look number three, it will essentially be a repeated silhouette with a little bit of a different top on look number three. Then the back view for look number four and six are very similar in terms of the upper bodies and the seams that you have on them. Other than that, you can also see the repetition of look number three and its sculptural folds on look number four, which is a smaller scaled down version. Also, when you're working with range plans, one of the helpful tips would be a scamber principle. You can Google what it is, but essentially it's for you to play around with silhouette and play around with proportion. It allows you to scale things up, scale things down. It just essentially is a reminder to work around and be playful with your collection. Now we're onto the biggest chunk of my work that I spent a lot of time onto, and that is technical specification sheets. They are detailed illustrations appropriately made in Illustrator that outline every little aspect of every garment that went into every look. We had to create at least six for every garment, but I think in some cases I had more, just because the details were so intricate and there was so much complication in the construction process. I had to draw out my own grid, because we were not giving a specific structure for us to follow. We were just given a couple of examples and we were allowed to create our own grids if we wanted to. So you'll see a repetition in pages. I started with page number one, which essentially shows you a front and back view of your illustrated piece, and I began with trousers from look number one. On the top right corner, you see that I drew a little square with L1 representing look one, and you'll see that repeating and changing throughout the looks. Page number two is a finishing page where you can actually see every little detail about it, that I kept bias binding inside, that I wanted to use a metal zipper, I wanted to use snap buttons, and so on. Then you can see a surface manipulation page, a print page, and then a print placement page. I use Photoshop to fill it in. In the same look number one, I made the top. top. Again, front, back view, finishing view, print and print placement. There was not too much to discuss here because it's quite self-explanatory. Moving on to look number two, it's a patchwork leather skirt, again front and back view, and a bit of measurements regarding the size. I have not made the skirt, so I can't really say what exactly the measurements are. That's why they're quite vague, just height and width, which would not be the case when you're actually making a piece. But so again, construction page, I wanted to make event, I wanted to have a zipper in the back, there is an extension pocket coming from the front, then surface manipulation and little photo of the manipulations that I made because they were quite specific, then a print, and this page acts as a print placement page as well because there is not really much to discuss here, just print goes on the inside of the lining of that pocket, so I didn't make a separate sheet just for it. Top for look number two, it's quite specifically constructed, but it's again explained pretty well in my opinion. Surface manipulations, print placement again, and here is that giant sculptural backpack for look number two. For construction, I actually took inspiration from a travel backpack and I broke it down into layers and decided to insert sculptural elements into seams. Just outlined what kind of surface manipulations I wanted to have, what kind of print I'm using, and where I'm placing it. We're moving on to my favorite trousers from look number three. I probably have the most amount of pages for that one because they're so difficult in construction. As you can see, the finishing and how specific details are inserted into one another, fused, and there's so many details, just I can't even bother. Current placements, and now we're moving on to the top. As you can see, the shoulders are a bit extended and they're going beyond the body, and the sleeves are doubled just because I have to keep that paperclip incision somehow, and the print of the body top is essentially the same as top for look number one, just in a different color. Another one of my favorites, look number four. This is a coat, but it's constructed very specifically. As you can see, there is a whole another coat that goes into the construction for the draping, and it is representative of the security check on dressing and how you're kind of throwing things on top of yourself once you're done with all the documents and all the clothing. I think I went a little crazy. I have 8 different prints, and I have sublimation print, lino cuts, seal screen, and mono print in here. So I have absolutely no idea how I'm going to be actually physically making it once we're back and running in the studio, but it sure is going to pose me a challenge. This is a similar to look number one top. It's a bodysuit that goes underneath this one, but it's also very simple and I only have 3 pages for it because I know how to make it, and also just one solid print goes all over the top once it's done because it is a leather print transfer that happens underneath a heat press, which I just discovered while I was working without any sublimation printer because it wasn't working. Look number five, quite simple. It's just a dress, but it has an understructure where you sort of are pinning the dress into, and it does look similar to the bodysuit. So again, you're sort of repeating this different little elements throughout the collection for you to keep the production methods simple and a little bit more fast forwarded, because if I were to make different bodysuit cuts on this bodysuit that goes underneath the dress and bodysuit that went on look number four, it will be such a pain in the ass to just make new patterns and recreate everything, especially in a short amount of time. Final look, yay, but it is consisting of 3 different layers, so I'm just gonna go briefly through them. This is a dress with a very intricate construction and print placement. These are the leggings inspired by look number five and the way that the pleats are constructed by being tucked into the base layer, and the top, which is an exact repetition of top for look number one because I need some repetition in my work. As promised, I'm gonna be filming you another sketchbook tour because I managed to fill out an entire second sketchbook for this degree collection, so keep an eye out for that one because it's coming next week. This is my degree collection evaluation, which you can read underneath in the description of my previous video with it, which I uploaded on Monday. The video itself is a tour down the process of degree collection construction with the adaptation to the digital world. So there is a lot of process of collection in process with mood boards, with starting points, and 360 GIF animations of every look of my collection. So check it out, I'll leave a link down below and in the clickable I button. With our focus shifting from physical to digital world, we had to make our portfolio as beautiful as possible, and I think that was the first time that I managed to keep a uniform aesthetic throughout the portfolio. If I went through all of those 35 pages, it would have been a like 2-hour long video. I'm gonna keep a tour down my portfolio, degree collection portfolio, for the week right after my sketchbook tour, so keep an eye out for that one as well. As an extra little piece, as well as that video that I just showed you, I made a little animation, GIF animation, of all of my range plans that I made before the actual final one, because our tutor suggested that in the beginning of the year. She, I think, will be very excited to see how my collection developed from very abstract, very raw, unfinished ideas to an actual finished collection. And as you can see, it changed the aesthetic drastically multiple times with different prints, with different color combinations. But I think I am very glad with how it turned out because it looks way more simple, cleaner, and with the amount of crazy shapes, silhouettes, and prints, the more toned down, very calm aesthetic of a color palette works best with my collection, in my opinion. another little extra piece for my degree collection. It's a 360 animation of all of my designs at the same time, so I think it's quite interesting to see how they perform next to each other, especially now when we don't know whether or not we're going to be showing our work on the runway show in October. This is an option for you to see a little bit of movement of my clothes, even though I just animated them flat laid. And the last little piece that I made for this collection would be my Instagram mask, which was my first time ever using augmented reality and creating a filter myself. So don't judge too harshly. I know it's a bit wonky, it's not exactly a perfect fit, especially for someone with a 7 head like mine. So just test it, check it out. It was an interesting choice for me to play around with augmented reality, especially now with the 21st century where technology is moving so fast, and I do think we should be adapting for them. So check it out if you're interested and tag me if you use it.
Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed this video. I also hope that for those people who have no idea what goes into fashion design, this video was helpful, and now you can realise the amount of work that goes into it is just tremendous. It is just as stressful and difficult and time consuming as any other job. During the 4 years that I've studied in university, I've gotten the craziest amount of experience, a lot of different fashion skills, a lot of different professional skills as well, so I hope your education is just as exciting and interesting as mine is, and if not, I do encourage you to try to find something that will bring you joy. So thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.